Friends, you are all welcome to this video. Today, in this video, we will study the surface area of right circular cone.
Manas, today in school, we are organizing a party to celebrate Ramu Chacha's birthday. All the children are going to bring something or the other to the party. What are you going to bring?
I am thinking of making hats for all the people who will be coming to the party. But I can't figure out how much paper will I need to make each hat.
You can find the solution through mathematics. That means it's math time! Manas, can you tell me by what name is this shape of the hat better known?
I don't know, Thomas.
We call the shape of the cap a right circular cone. Here, point A is called the vertex of this right circular cone, AB its height, and BC is the radius of its base. And do you know something new? AC is called slant height of this cone, and here B is the center of the base, which is circular in shape.
I understood all this, but how does this relate to the paper used in my hats?
I'll tell you. See, if we cut this cone-shaped cap along any side or edge, going from the top of it and open it in this way, we will find that the paper of this shape makes the surface of your conical cap. In other words, the size or the area of this paper will be equal to the curved surface area of the cone. Correct?
Oh, wow! Thomas, this is very interesting. But there is a difficulty. We do not know the formula for the curved surface area of a cone.
Never mind if we don't know it yet. Let us find this formula. Look, Manas, the side where we cut the cone will be its slant height, which we will express with L. Now, if we divide the paper into hundreds of small pieces by lines going from O, then these sliced parts will look almost triangular in shape. And the interesting thing is that the height of each of these is equal to the slant height L of the cone. Look, Manas, each piece is in the shape of a triangle. So, can you tell me the area of each triangle?
The area of each triangle will be 1 by 2 times its base multiplied by the height, which is L here.
Well done! And see, the area of the entire paper will be equal to the sum of the areas of all these pieces. Now, if we represent the bases of all these triangles by writing B1, B2, B3, etc. respectively, then we can write the sum of the areas of all these triangles in this way.
But Thomas, B1, B2, B3, etc. together make up the outer part of this shape. So, the sum of all these will be equal to the length of the curved boundary of this shape.
That's absolutely right. And this curved part forms the base of the cone. And as we know, the circumference of this base will be 2 pi r, where r is the radius of the base.
Oh, wow, Thomas! The area of the paper is equal to the curved surface area of the cone. So look, we get the formula for the curved surface area of the cone, where R is the radius of the base and L is the slant height of the cone.
And look, if we consider the height of the cone as h, then from the Pythagoras theorem, we can see that we can write the slant height of the cone in this way. And do you know, Manas, if the base of the cone is supposed to be kept closed, we will need a circular piece of paper with radius r to cover the base. The area of this circular piece of paper will be pi r squared. Now, if we add it to the formula for the curved surface area of the cone, then we will get the formula of total surface area of cone.
Let me quickly solve this by writing R and L in the formula for the curved surface area of the cone by writing the radius of the base of my cap as 5 centimeters and the slant height of the cap as 14 centimeters respectively. Look, Thomas, I would need 220 square centimeters of paper to make one hat.
Let us quickly write both these formulae in the formula booklet and return to our world. I'll help you make your hats, huh?
The two friends together made many hats and celebrated Ramu Chacha's birthday in a grand manner. In this video, we studied the surface area of right circular cone. In the next video, we will see some interesting examples based on this.